Norman is in, and I guess the Knights need to find their groove again.
Yeah, important games coming up. We'll see if they can find their groove again. Hello, Tara. Good to see you tonight. Guelphs at JLC this evening. The Storm are fighting for their playoff lives while your Knights find themselves in a bit of a struggle. If they're going to hold off the Whalers, they're going to need a few more W's from Michael Hauser. Mike has 43 wins right now. He needs three more over the final 2 weeks to help clinch the Knights' first place overall and put himself into the record books, reaching 46 victories for the season, would tie him with former Spitfire Andrew Angelage for most in an OHL campaign.
I think I'll make it three or four starts here down the stretch, so it's in the back of my head, but again, it's not something that that I'm going to key on. It's it's one of those things that if we win games, then it'll take care of itself, and that's everyone's goal here, is to win games.
The Lightning go for the series clinch tomorrow evening at John Labatt Center. Pro playoff basketball is new to the city, but old hat for the guys involved. Brent explains. On the Junior B ice, Strathroy and St. Mary's can advance with playoff victories tonight. After dusting off LaSalle, the Nats are moving on, but took a little time to have some fun first. Merrick got in on it.
But today was about having some laughs and enjoying playoff success. Merrick Sutherland, CTV News.
You have to have fun. Thank you, Merrick. Former champions Glenn Howard and Kevin Cooey square off in the round-robin finale at the Tim Hortons Brier in Saskatoon tonight. Howard is 9-1, Cooey 8-2. It could be a preview of Sunday's final game. 2-2 TFC LA Galaxy, 47,658, saw a pretty entertaining football match at Rogers Center last night, and David Beckham nearly get dinged with a beer can. But that wasn't his major issue with the night.
I'm glad the game was staged here because I knew it was a bigger stadium.
What's at stake now for Becks and his crew, plus the Leafs losing more in the real. Ottawa at the New York Rangers tonight should be a beauty, with both clubs showing lots of promise in the Eastern Conference standings. New York sits atop the thing, Ottawa 3 points out of fifth. A ton of games this evening with playoff implications. Just not Montreal at Edmonton. Both teams are lottery teams. Those Leafs dumped in Pittsburgh, their second straight loss, 3-2 the final. They had a two-goal lead, too. They can't come out of early disadvantages, and even when they get up, it's still bad news in the end. That's 12 losses in 14 games for Toronto, and really the playoff dream is over now. The Penguins have won seven straight, licking their chops for a long playoff run, and the return of Sidney Crosby. 2-2 TFC Galaxy at a wild Rogers Center last night. Thanks to a fan who threw a beer can at David Beckham, LA pretty much tied it up late. Why? Beckham would take his time to complain about debris coming at him while his mates could take their time to set up for his corner kick. And they'd deliver. Had TFC won the game, they would have been in the driver's seat heading to California for the second leg of this quarterfinal next week. Now they pretty much need a victory to seal the deal. Those Toronto Raptors continue to play well and win from time to time. 116-98 over Houston at Air Canada Center. The Raps are 4-6 over their past 10, but have been in every one of those games. They are 13-26 on the season. And where is Peyton Manning going to end up? Thoughts? Predictions? Denver could use a quarterback. There it is, your sports reel. Why not the Broncos? In spring training, the Tigers undefeated. 6-0 after beating up on Tampa Bay this afternoon. 8-1, the Jays dumped the Yanks 6-1. So the Knights are in need of wins. The Storm in need of wins. Should be a good game at JLC. We'll have the action at 11.
All right, sounds good. Thanks so much, Norm.